Morning student, hope so you are fit and fine at your home. Today we going to start our chapter number 2, log on to access. Log on to access, before this video we have discussed about the MS Access. What is MS Access? We have discussed already, and how to open MS Access we have described. Today we going to start how to create database in MS Access. So let's continue, students. Adding a table, regardless of how you have created your database, you can add new table to an existing database in various way. These are adding table in design view, adding table in the datasheet view, adding table using a table templates, adding table in design view. We have discussed in this. Click on the table design button on the create tab in the table design group. A table will be created and opened in the design view. Adding field in design view means how can we add field. For each field in the table, type a name in the field name column and then press the table tab key. Move the data types. By default, show text data type appears in the column. You select any data type. In the description column, you can type the description for each field, which is optional. The description text is displayed on the status bar when the cursor points to that field in the dataset view. After defining all the fields, save the table by clicking on Save option in the File tab. Select the Save, press Present on the Quick Access toolbar. Now to add data in the table, switch to the dataset view. Click on View, dataset view, and click Yes button. So now your table will be created. Adding table in dataset view. When you create a blank database, SS creates a table automatically. You can either customize this table or create another table by using the create tab. To create a table in the dataset view, click on the create tab and select the table button in the table group. And a new blank table will be created and opened in the dataset view. You see in this picture we have created a blank table in dataset view. Adding a table, adding field in dataset view. SS automatically created the first field called ID. You can see there is ID. The data type, this field number will means the SS will be automatically generate a sequential number in the field for each new record. You can add a new cell to the table by entering the data in click to add column. SS will be automatically assign a data type based on the data you enter. Let us enter the first record. Click on the empty field below the click to add header. Enter the name of the student, for example Priya, and then press either the tab or enter key. You will notice that SS has assigned value 1 to ID field and name the second column as a field 1. Now the click to add level shift to the third column. Observe that the icon in the rows selector changed to the pencil, which indicate that record has been changed but not saved. The asterisk sign move its next row. Observe that two tab fields and table appear on the ribbon. Under the table tool, contextual tab. Enter the required data. Press the tab key after each entry. Save the table by selecting the save icon present on the quick access toolbar. Write the name of file and click on OK. And your file will be saved. So next is rule for the naming of field. How can we write the field? As you already know that our table has multiple fields and each field have unique table. Each field has its own name and data type. Following are the some rules for naming field. A field name can be ranged from 1 to 64 characters. A field name can be include letter, number, and some special characters. Generally, the underscore sign is used. A field name cannot start with a blank space. A field name can be in the upper, lower, or mixed case. A field name cannot have a period, full stop, exclamation, brackets, and grow account. You can change the property of the field name, that is storage, size, format, and validation rule by specifying certain characteristics in the field properties span. So, data type. What are the data type we have discussed here? Every table consists of the field and every field has its own set of properties which describe the characteristics and behavior of the data added to the field. The most important property for the field is its data type. A field data type determines what types of data you can enter into the field. For example, a field whose data type is number. Agar kisi ka number hai, can only store numeric data and does not allow you to enter text data into it. The following table depict the available data types in Access 2016. So what is data type? Data type is a declared field. So data type first is stored. It uses the store text or combination of the text and number that does not require calculations such as addresses, phone number, etc. Means isme calculation nahi hai, wahan pe hum short type data use karenge. The field with this data type can have maximum of 255 character. Hum isme sirf 255 character ko hi insert kar sakte hain. Long text, it store the text or number up to 65,536 character. It is used for descriptive field. Descriptive field के means जिसमें हमने description देनी है उस type के field में हम use करते हैं. Number, it store the numeric information that you can use for the calculation. A number data type can store integer value as well as decimal value. The maximum size of the number field can be 16 bytes. So next data type is date and time. It store data, date and time value. You can display dates and time in the various format. Thus, the maximum size used by the data type is 8 byte. Calculation related to date and time can be done in this field type. Okay, agar aapne date mention karni hai to date and time type define karenge. Currency, this type is used to store monetary data up to 8 byte. Next is auto number. It generates a sequential number whenever a new record is added to the table. The value into the auto number field can not be changed. Means hum change nahi kar sakte iske value. It store data as 4 byte value typically used to create an identify column which unique identifies each record in the table. Okay, now next is yes or no. It used at the place where the field cannot have only one possible values. It store the boolean types of data, either be true or either be false. या तो yes होगा answer या no होगा answer. That case we use yes or no type of data. For example, a student can either be a male or a female. Next is OLE, object. This is used to embed it on an object created in another application such as Microsoft Word document, Excel spreadsheet or PowerPoint presentation into the access table. It stores up to 2 GB data. Next is hyperlink. Hyperlink data type can store link to the web pages and websites files on an intranet or LAN on your computer. It stored up to the 1 GB of data. Attachment, which file you want to attach. This type data allow you to attach images, spreadsheet file, documents, charts and both types of supported files to the record in your database, much similar to the manner you attach file to the image. Calculated, this data type is used when a user creates a table field that calculates value. The calculation can be include value from field in the same table as well as built-in access functions. This data type is used mostly in case of query, form and table. Lookup wizard helps you to create a field whose value are chosen from the value in another table, query or list of value. By default, a access set lookup field to the number data types. Okay, so student, hope so student you understand this topic. Thank you.